Matthews sparks Leafs past Blackhawks in OT. Patrick Kane has an admirer in Auston Matthews. And the feeling is mutual. I was just really impressed with not only his shot and quick release, but the way he battles for pucks, Kane said Monday, before his Chicago Blackhawks fell 4-3 to the Maple Leafs at the Air Canada Centre, with Matthews firing home the winner in overtime. Matthews had the better night overall, controlling the offensive zone and helping his line generate 28 chances, to just 9 by the Hawks when he was on the ice. The young Leaf also led both teams with 8 shots on goal, with Kane held to 2. Chicago built a 2-0 first period lead on goals by Jan Rutter and Jonathan Tarrus, but the Leafs made adjustments and cut the lead to 2-1 in the second on an Nikita Zaitsev goal. Then, with Andreas Borgman in the penalty box after a clean-looking body check on Chicago's Alex DeBrincat, the Hawks cashed in again on a Richard Panik goal for a 3-1 cushion. The Leafs rebounded again and were the better team over the final 30 minutes. They outshot Chicago 14-6 in the third, including Connor Brown's first goal of the season and the game-tying marker by James Van Riemsdyk. Kane, like most players, fans and media types, has no problem projecting a limitless future for the Leafs' 20-year-old center, last season's Rookie of the Year. The prolific Chicago winger is something of a role model for Matthews, both American-born stars drafted first overall, Kane 10 years ago. Asked if he would like to play a similar role with the next wave of U.S. players, Matthews didn't hesitate. "For sure," Matthews said. "Kane's pedigree, everything he has earned over his career, is pretty incredible. He's a good role model for U.S. hockey. We have a lot of guys coming up." Kane and Matthews have been part of the early season scoring burst around the NHL, which has been led by Alex Ovechkin and Connor McDavid. A crackdown on slashing and stickwork has translated into more open ice, with the league's elite players taking full advantage. Both Kane and Matthews are quick to add, however, that defense is vital and that the explosion of goals might not last long. Kane says the fact that Matthews gets that at a young age is a big part of what makes his performance so impressive. The two skated together for the first time this summer, and Kane came away impressed by the Leafs' overall skills. "The biggest thing you notice off the ice is how big he is," Kane said of Matthews. "He's 20, but he has a man's body." A decade ago, Kane and Leafs winger James Van Riemsdyk were the first and second overall picks in the NHL draft. Since then, Kane has averaged more than a point a game. Matthews recalled that when he started watching Kane highlights on YouTube in his early teens, the inspiration was there to be like Kane. "He's one of my favorite players to watch, and I try to see what he does and try to translate it into my game," Matthews said. "He's been an unbelievable example for a lot of American kids, for myself. Playing against him, it's pretty cool." Kane has meshed beautifully in the early going with 21-year-old center Nick Schmaltz, drafted 20th overall by the Blackhawks in 2014, one of 10 new players on the roster after last year's disappointing 4-game sweep at the hands of the Nashville Predators in the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. "Nick had a great training camp," Kane said of his center, whose preseason performance led coach Joel Quenneville to pair the two on opening night. "We've been playing together for a month now, so we're developing that chemistry. I played with Artem Anisimov, traded in Columbus, the last few years, so right now we're talking a lot, with Schmaltz, about how we want to play and where we are on the ice." Leafs defenseman Morgan Rielly said Kane was the hardest player to defend against in the league. Asked how he felt about admiration from younger NHLers, Kane replied, "Old, I guess.